Super Bowl, and this historic matchup is brought to you by EA Sports. It's the Fins and the Silver and Black, and it comes your way next.
The final act of the 2023 season is at hand. What a spectacle in Las Vegas. We're off in Super Bowl 58. And they'll let that one go as it skips through the back of the end zone for a touchback. So here comes the Raider offense now onto the field. And leading them out there, we get a look at their 6'3 quarterback.
And as we know and as we've discussed here in the run-up to this game, this is history in the making. The first rookie quarterback to ever start in a Super Bowl. An absolutely tremendous accomplishment, something no one else has done. But he doesn't want to just go down as the first to make a Super Bowl. He's told us all week he's here to win it.
So the completion good for 7 there, and that'll bring up second down. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
I haven't met a quarterback yet that didn't enter the league with a massive chip on his shoulder. If he wasn't a first-round pick, they want to show the league that they made a big mistake. Determined to get the first down there, no hesitation at all to tuck it and go. I bet he would have tried running through their entire defense if it meant reaching that marker.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. And he's able to break out a one tackle, but then quickly brought down.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Got his man complete over the middle. It's Jacobs. 5 yards on first down, but now just a 1 yard pickup there on second.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
First carry for Josh Jacobs. And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
A lot depended on the spot there, and he got it. But it wasn't by much, was it? I remember Coach Madden talking about, depending on which foot the official used, that would tell you whether you had the first down or not. You want that upfield foot to be the one that spots the ball, don't you?
And you and I have the luxury of a couple extra views here in the booth, and he did get it, but not by much. Give him a first down, 15 yards that time for the Raiders. Really a solid start here on the opening drive, Charles. He's now 4-4, and they're already in plus territory.
Brandon, he's been so precise to start this game, like we're watching an operation taking place right now. Master surgeon at work.
O'Connell on first and 10. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Barton, I came into this game eager to see how they would hold up in man coverage. And on that play, they held up quite well.
They'll try a little trickery here on the end around. And a great job there to read that one defensively. They strung him out, would not allow him to cut up field. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. O'Connell's going to sneak it, and he is going to have the Raiders' first down, at least at first glance, as they'll spot the football just beyond the marker. They find a way to convert on third and inches. Oh, a design run for their wideout. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Jacoby Myers, a 21-yard touchdown run. And the Raiders are on the board first here in this Super Bowl. That was a really good opening drive on a number of fronts. 10 plays, very methodical, set the tone.
So you know right now, if you're on the defensive side of the ball, you're on the sideline saying, okay, what do we have to dial up in order to get off the field a lot faster? Because both sides are out there for 10 plays, but one side comes off energized, and the other side comes off with some questions.
And they'll try a little razzle-dazzle. And he will get in to make it 8-0. And what a way to cap off the opening touchdown drive. You go for two and you get it.
Remember when the PAT or the extra point was a gimme, right? Not plus 99%. It's not that way anymore. So more people are willing to take a chance, go for two, and take the kicker a little bit out of the game.
Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. And this will be a touchback. Berrios deciding not to bring it out. Two in the Dolphins now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll run here with Raheem Mostert. They'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31.
Brandon, to me, what's important right here on this drive is for them to get at least two first downs. They've got to give their defense a chance to settle down, catch their breath a little bit after they give up a touchdown on the opening drive.
Unable to corral him, he fights through. He's still on his feet. He may go. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Raheem Mostert, 69 yards. And the Dolphins are able to strike quickly here as they are in for six. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And this is now a one-point game. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. Second drive of the game coming up for this Las Vegas offense. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Now a second and 10. Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon. Oh, moving from his tight end spot there.
Do you think that perhaps the play call was for him?
And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Can't really fault the coverage. The ball was tipped and popped up in the air, but they were unable to complete the tip drill for the interception.
Well, now they'll try the end around. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30. Boy, a nice play there as they wind up converting on third and 15. And they'll run it here. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 23 yards on the play.
This is one of those plays that has an equal chance of either being a big gain or a big loss, but with the college influence, we're seeing more of these plays come into the NFL.
So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 48-yard line. To throw here, O'Connell eluding the pressure running. And he lost the football. That brings us to the end of one in Super Bowl 58. Much more to come from Las Vegas after this. Welcome back to the date on the calendar we circle every year, Super Bowl Sunday. Brandon Gaughton, Charles Davis here with you as we get set to begin quarter two. The fumble on first down, now here's second down. O'Connell now off the bootleg. Well, that'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
It's always tough trying to keep your guy upright when he's trying to throw the football. When you're dealing with those big, bad guys on the defensive front, it's even tougher. And this time, those guys on the opposite side won the battle, getting to the quarterback and knocking him into an incompletion.
And he is going to have the Raiders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, partner, if we had their entire playbook in front of us, I'm not sure we would have picked out that play as the one to run in that situation. How about the guts of the offensive coordinator dialing that one up and to great success?
And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. No one there to help out downfield, but no problem. Scrambling for 22 and a first. Charles, in the past, a lot of people called this offense one-dimensional.
I think you did.
Well,
I think it was you.
I'll be honest, I did. I think the fan base is hoping with this young rookie that they can put some wrinkles in this offense like we just saw.
I think you're exactly right, because we did have that discussion that what we've seen in the past from them, they needed to broaden, and they have done it here. Look at what he's bringing to their offense, and now as a defensive coordinator, you've got some extra work to do to prepare for him and their offense.
Now, this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. From the five now, second and a yard. Carter with it. And he's over the line and in for a Raider touchdown. DeAndre Carter, a 5-yard touchdown run as his guys are able to extend their lead. This feels like something we'd see more commonly, CD, in a college game. They give it to the receiver down here in the red zone, but it winds up successful.
Yeah, partner, I think you think it's less likely to find running space to the edge down here close to the end zone where things are so condensed. But a lot of times you end up focusing on the running backs, and they're able to slip it to the receiver, and it resulted in a touchdown.
And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. Boy, I guess they're going to keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. And the Raiders have recovered. I don't know many coaches that would have the guts, the nerve to do this in the Super Bowl, but they did it, and it paid off.
Well, if you were a head coach, you would have done it. I know you. You have that type of nerve, similar to Sean Payton in Super Bowl IV.
Oh, that's right.
In New Orleans when he did it against Indianapolis.
That's exactly right, by the way. Definitely would not have kicked. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. And they'll go with a ground attack here. Fights loose. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. The pickup goes for 16 and a Raider first down. They'll run here with Carter. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. They give him a gain of 37.
This is one of those plays that could go either way, but we've seen the influence of the college game now in the NFL, but we're seeing more and more of these plays run, and that one went for a big gain.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Oh, how about this on first and goal? And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Jacoby Myers, his second touchdown of the Super Bowl. And the Raiders continue to look good here in the first half of this Super Bowl. CD, that's his second touchdown already. And how about this offense? Three drives, three touchdowns.
An absolute total team effort right now. And let's face it, I don't think he's done. We're still in the first half. There's a lot of time left to go. I don't know what they're going to do on the other side trying to slow him down. But right now, he's feeling it.
And they'll try a little razzle-dazzle. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up two more. guess they're going to keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. And they've got it. They recovered it. But hang on now, though. There's a penalty flag down. Yeah, we saw that one up here, CD. Offensive team, they touched that before it went 10 yards.
Obviously such a fine line, letting it go the required 10 yards, but also getting to it before the hands team can. Just didn't time it out right, and that results in a flag.
On first down, nothing opening up really on the running play. Give him maybe a yard, and it'll be second down. 2 minutes on the clock in the second quarter of this Super Bowl. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. To his throw, caught by his receiver Hill. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. 22 yards there, a first down. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. Getting this out to the flat, Mostert. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. It'll be a gain of 5, and it'll be second down. Tua sets up to pass it. He'll dump this off to Achane. They'll get nothing out of that one, and it's going to lead to a third down.
That's a nice job defensively to make sure everyone was accounted for, because ordinarily, you pick up the guys downfield, and sometimes you forget about the running back. In this case, they did not and dropped him for no gain.
And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as he's able to get 8 yards there on 3rd and 5. Now a 1st and 10 at the 11. From the gun, it's Tua. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
The storm windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. Durham Smythe. From 4 yards out, and the Dolphins get a late score here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point up and good by Sanders, and this is back to an 8-point game. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive. And with an 8-point lead, probably not too much of an impetus to try and do too much here. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. And they'll go on the ground. And that one covered beautifully. The defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And a great job there to read that one defensively. They strung him out, would not allow him to cut up field. So it's halftime here on sports' grandest stage in the Super Bowl. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
We saw a couple of high-octane offenses getting it done in the first half. Both teams had no problems moving the football. And you'd have to think, the team whose defense shows up in the second half is going to be the one who walks out of here with a victory. Both these teams, no doubt, making their final halftime adjustments as we speak. And for the call of the second half, we get it back out to Brandon Gunn and Charles Davis.
And how about this right out of the locker room, an onside kick attempt. These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action. action here in this Super Bowl. A gutsy call there. Yeggs at the locker room with a lead. Tried the onside kick. It didn't work.
And you just wonder what the gain was there. They were already in the lead. They were in control of the game. They may have given momentum now to their opponent and maybe kick-started things going in the opposite direction.
And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. A Miami first down, that one going for a gain of 11. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. Got a man, it's Berrios complete. They'll give him 4 yards there, and that will bring up second down. Up the middle they go with Mostert. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up third and five.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Tagovailoa working out of the gun. And he's going to go down here. A sack. They push him back to the 34. They dial up the corner blitz that time, and it delivers to the tune of a 9-yard loss. The kick by Sanders is good, and that'll get the lead down to 5. So as it turns out, that sack doesn't wind up costing them, Charles. They at least get points, get 3 of them.
Yeah, that's where your kicker can really come to your rescue, because you know after the sack, there was a little consternation there. Are we out of field goal range? Are we going to be able to get 3? In this case, he stepped right up and gave him exactly what they needed.
So here comes the Raiders offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. They'll start the drive here with an end around. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. And O'Connell now to throw. And he'll only get a yard to bring up 3rd and 1.
Just a second earlier, and they might have had him because they certainly thought they were going to close in and drop him behind the line of scrimmage, but he had just enough time to dodge the pressure, and he ends up getting yardage before being stopped.
O'Connell's going to sneak it, and boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. Boy, a call like this, certainly tougher to make in a Super Bowl, but they'll go for it on 4th down. And boy, that's going to be close. He didn't get much at all there, but he got the first. Looked like they might have held him defensively, but the referee signals it will be a first down. And they'll run it here. And he's going to have another first down here as he's able to dive beyond the marker. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. A couple of first downs on the drive already as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he's across midfield and into Miami territory. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's 3rd down. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Trying a little razzle-dazzle on 3rd and short. And he will have 1st down yardage as he's brought down at the 41.
Holding offense.
Colton Miller, former first-round pick, called for the penalty there. So following the holding call, what can they do here on 3rd and long? They'll run. It's Carter. They find some open field here. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A big 3rd down conversion with a gain of 28.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense gets a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. through three quarters of play here from Allegiant Stadium in Super Bowl 58. Folks, welcome back to the biggest stage in sports, the Super Bowl, and now we get down to the good stuff, the fourth and final quarter. Here's Jacobs on first and 10. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. Two chunk plays in a row. The last one was over 20 yards, and so is this one.
As I take a look at the clock, I realize that this drive has eaten up a good portion of the fourth quarter already. I gotta tell you, partner, when you're trying to salt away a game, this is exactly what it's supposed to look like.
So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Oh, how about this call down near the goal line? And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Jacoby Myers with his third touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Raiders are starting to pull away in the fourth quarter of this Super Bowl. Well, that's certainly going to bump up the old win probability index because now it's a two-score game here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you're taking me into that deep water now, win probability index. This game's definitely not over. We're not looking at a half percent or something. It's just two scores. But the way that this...
Diving for the end zone, and the ball's knocked out. Oh, one of the linebackers has got it.
Well, that two-point attempt failed due to the fumble, but people can't see this. But you got a ball in your hands now, and you've got the thing locked in pretty well. You've got it covered up.
I love having a football in the booth. I always hang on to it. It makes me feel like I actually played back in my day.
Well, you probably could have. If you had run that play, you would not have fumbled. I can tell you that.
Maybe. Yeah, you got to wait until that ball goes 10 yards. They did not. They hit it before, and that draws the flag every time.
And there's no doubt in my mind that converting an onside kick has never been tougher in the NFL with the new rules. So trying to get it to 10 yards, timing up perfectly, that's tough enough to begin with. But when you go ahead and grab it before it goes, you've got no shot then.
Here's second and 10. Looking to pass to him. And he'll complete this one to Berrios. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. 5 yards. Now it's third and five. They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. Tua gonna throw. He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Here's a toss play right to Mostert. And they'll get him down right around the 16. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Here's Tua. Oh, what a heck of an effort there as he'll make the diving catch. And the Dolphins are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the 1. Throwing now is Tagovailoa to the end zone, but it's incomplete. Down this close to the goal line, first down. Surprised that wasn't a run?
I am, and you know I'm old school. I want to run the ball on first down in this situation because second down, that gives me an option of running play action, maybe throwing it.
And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Raheem Mostert. His second touchdown of the Super Bowl. And the Dolphins have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. It's a run with Mostert.
Sometimes offensive can get too cute down near the goal line, but there's nothing fancy about this one. As Coach Lombardi would say, we get a seal here, and we get a seal here, and we run this play in the alley. And that's good work to hit the hole hard and finish in the end zone.
And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. The Raiders offense now, they trot back out. And the tension ratcheting up all around. A one-score game, fourth quarter of the Super Bowl. This is what you folks came for. Every play with the potential to win or lose a title as they look to drain some time off this clock. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down. he'll go on the ground. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 14 yards is the pickup there at a Raider first.
And while we're seeing more and more of these plays come from the college game into the NFL, and that one, it was run with great success. How about the evolution of the offensive linemen? We're seeing less and less big guys who can't move and more guys who are a lot more mobile and can get out in front of that type of a play.
Now Carter. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. Well, they'll take that every time with a lead, first down, fourth quarter, getting 8 yards. You love that.
They will take it, and you have to ask the defensive guys, why did you give it? I mean, you know the situation. You're down, have to stop them, have to get the football back. But 8 yards on first down puts them back on their heels.
3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So it's Raider football as we get you reset. This is third and two, maybe the biggest play in this football game. And they'll run it here. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
Well, when we go back to our conversation with the defensive coordinator, that type of a play was not a surprise to him. He expected trickery in this game, yet somehow his defense, they still took the cheese and got caught in the mousetrap.
Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. And they'll go with a ground attack here. This will be a 5-yard pickup as they move it from the 20 to the 15. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And that would cover beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. And here's a big one now, trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Oh, look at this play call. That one, a backbreaker as they wind up converting there on fourth. I got to tell you, I'm shocked. When I realized they were running the football at fourth and that distance, I thought that was a surefire throw.
I can hear it in your voice because I'm the exact same way. No one runs the football in this situation, right? You've got to throw it to have a chance unless you're them. Talk about supreme confidence bordering on arrogance, and they got it done keeping the ball on the ground to pick up the first down.
O'Connell's going to sneak it, and he gets halfway there from the 4 to the 2 on a gain of 2.
This has been an up-and-down, back-and-forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive take a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settle things down a little bit.
Time for this one final knee to put a bow on this title bout. And now we'll get a timeout here. They're able to stop it with 1 second to go in this game. Third and goal, a big play in this Super Bowl. And they'll go on the ground. And he takes it in for the score on the game's final play, so it doesn't affect the outcome. But a little whipped cream on top to their ending.
As our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little lagniappe, a little extra on top.
They got the touchdown, but a little risky, even though where they were to run the football in that situation on the final play.
If they give it up somehow, both turnovers
they tried to run the ball in that situation instead of just taking a knee and icing it.
But thankfully for them, they won't have to do any explaining. And how about this? Viva Las Vegas. The Las Vegas Raiders on top of the football world as they will hoist the Lombardi Trophy as Super Bowl champions. And when this moment comes, I think you look back at all the blood, sweat, and tears, the offseason, the workouts, training camp, week one, two, three, all building up now to say you're a Super Bowl champion. It's worth it.
It certainly is, and rarely do we have a team that hoists a Lombardi Trophy that didn't have their share of bumps along the way, didn't have to face some adversity in the journey, and now they get to just enjoy it and revel in it. And all offseason, they'll be signing their autographs with Super Bowl champion underneath it.